Well, Gordon, you brought me down to this Contactum three-phase distribution board, and you said we're going to talk about surge today.
Yeah, well, a lot of people investing now in surge protection for that sensitive equipment you might have in a factory or warehouse environment, but how many people actually check to see if those surge protection devices are functioning as intended?
So what are you suggesting, that we're not going to the surge device and looking to see if we can see a green or red window?
Well, I'm suggesting, yeah, people don't look behind this hidden door, behind this lovely mechanism, and peer through the window and notice if that flag has turned from green to red.
Okay, so what's the solution then if we're not visually looking at these surge arresters?
Well, we're going to find out how to make an indicator device that sits alongside the panel to show you the status of the surge protection device.
So you're telling me this green lamp here is equally indicating the fact that it's in a green status there?
Yes, exactly, Gary.
And if the surge arrester's life had gone and that window in there had turned to red, you're telling me this is going to turn to red?
Well, I'm hoping so.
Shall we take it to the bench?
Let's have a look.
So can you talk me through the process then?
Okay, so on a lot of surge protection devices, on the back you'll see these three connections there. So okay. These are volt-free contacts, so there's no power derived from the wires coming in from the circuit. But you can use those, normally open, normally closed, to trigger a device if the surge protection device has failed. So normally you'd see the flag change from green to red.
You would do.
Or if someone's removed the device itself, you'll see there's a little micro switch behind there, which again will change those contacts over.
Okay, so that also works for tampering. If somebody was to come along and actually just take those out, it would obviously indicate as well that they've been removed.
Hopefully, when we get to the end of this, we can simulate the failure by removing the device.
Okay, that makes sense. You've got a drawing in front of you as well. Is that going to help explain the connections we're going to need to make on the rig behind us?
Yeah, so the circuit I've designed here, we're going to use two industrial indicators, 22mm holes in there. I've actually, amazing how straight I got those holes in there, Gary.
Yeah, I bet they didn't come already pre-cut into the enclosure, did they?
That's a top tip. You can buy those enclosures pre-drilled, ready to take them. Normally you might see the start and stop button in there.
Okay.
So if I pick up this famous sketch.
Okay, an LS Lousy. Okay, brilliant sketch though. Yeah.
So we're going to take the neutral conductor straight out to the indicators itself.
Right.
Common demo up on the back already there.
Using the blue and the flex.
And then I've got the common from the line conductor.
Which we're going to pick up in here.
We're going to pick that, we're going to rob that from the supply to the metering device that's in there. And then it's a case of taking the normally open contact out to the fail lamp, which is the red one.
And that will not be illuminated under normal conditions.
That's it. Yep. So it's, and then the normally closed, when everything's healthy, we're going to take out to the green lamp.
And the green lamp will be permanently illuminated under normal conditions.
That's it.
Okay. So we've put the assembly here for our okay and failed indicators that we saw on the bench. We've passed our conductors in and we've now got to make our connections for our permanent line and neutral. We've already picked up our line conductor here using a double ferrule. Our cable's coming down here through these fuse sections, then feed our meter, and we thought it was best to come off this fuse section here. So I've just got to make the neutral connection here, but I've also got to join the neutral that we're needing for our indicator. So we're going to join those together in a double ferrule. If you haven't seen our video on improving electrical connections using ferrules, I recommend you check that one out. Then what we've got to do is just follow it through. So our line that we've already made comes through to here and goes into our common connection. And then this side, we've got our normally closed connection, which we've got to make for our green indicator, and our normally open on the other side for our failed indicator. So we're going to make those off as well. So let's start off by doing this double ferrule. So I just need to strip back these cables like so. I'm going to twist the conductors together and then just put a double ferrule on it. So we take those, and I'm just going to twist them up, and we're going to use a double ferrule. Just improves that connection, just makes it a little bit more secure where we're going into the actual dim rail itself. Take my ferrule crimping tool, just crimp that one up, and then if I can see what I'm doing, I'm just going to pop that into there. Connect my neutral up into there, and then it's just a matter of making two final connections. So that one's in like so, and now we can just follow it through to here. And I know that when that goes in here, my connection this side is the normally closed, and then we've got the normally open, and we've cleverly indicated them, green one for our normally closed and red one for our normally open. Need to take the green one for our normally closed to be the first of our terminals. Got a slightly smaller screwdriver in my hand, I can tighten those up, and then we can do the red one in our second terminal for our normally open, like so. And then we just pop that into the bottom of the surge, and then we should be able to indicate when that surge arrestor's life has expired. So just pop that in under here. And we're ready to see what happens when we energize that up. I think then what we can do is pull one of these out. That will effectively make it out to be a fail, and we should see the lamps change. So we've powered up our board, we're under control conditions, we've got this panel removed. We've got it removed, but I'm a little bit concerned, going, I've got a red failed indicator my side.
Good reason for that, Gary. I've removed one of the surge protection devices, and that's mimicking a device failed, which happened in two ways. Either someone has removed the device and not replaced it, or if the device had so many hits because of surges, is the little red indicator appears. But actually when that happens, a mechanical mechanism inside moves, would move this little pin on the back and trigger the microswitch in the same way.
So that moves forward, allowing it actually to pull out as we're in this position here. So I'm hoping that when you put that back in, we close that circuit and the green lamp will illuminate.
I'm hoping the same, Gary, otherwise my diagram was wrong at the start. So put the module back in. Lights changed.
We like that. Okay. So there's one thing that I've considered while we've been doing this. We could have taken the actual feed from the breaker that fed the surge and gone through and done our circuit. Why didn't we do that, Gordon?
Okay, well, that if someone had switched off the breaker, then both lights would not be on. So then again, you're relying on somebody spotting that actually there's no lights on.
Okay, so in this case, coming off a slightly different circuit that was fused down that we thought we'd use, it means that even if you turn off the breaker for the surge, we're actually still got a green light indicated?
Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Do that. So that could be a potential problem, but I'm sure the viewers can sort that one out.
So we're always interested in your comments, okay? Are you currently fitting surge devices and how are you getting on with doing that? Have you ever fitted an indicator lamp or siren to show that the fact that it's failed or in a healthy state? We'd be interested in your comments below. And we'll try and get back to as many as we can.